She will be commenting on first the presentation by Katrina Johnson, who received her bachelor's degree at Florida State, and she then moved to Atlanta, to Emory University, where she got a PhD in clinical psychology, and then has joined the faculty. She's going to be talking about using the infant brain activity to better understand bipolar disorders.
Very early in development. In terms of the areas of the brain, again, been motion dysregulation. So even at 6 months of age, babies of bipolar mothers compared with babies of healthy mothers, and even those with just unipolar depression, really show some kind of unique profiles. So in the current proposed study that we're getting underway, we're planning to look at 30 healthy newborns, about 15 in each group, and we're going to run them through a scanning protocol at our children's hospital, where we will be looking at their resting state brain activity. So they will not be sedated, they will be asleep, and it's about a 10 to 13 minute scan where we're going to get both structural data as well as functional data. And our hypotheses basically center around the idea that differences in connectivity, both within certain areas implicated in emotional dysregulation and between those kind of basal ganglia and prefrontal cortex networks, may be disrupted, and that these may